Hi guys, it's time to continue working on the aviary. This time I will work on the roof and the mesh. After these parts are completed, it will almost be time for the introduction of some new birds. This is where we left off, after we completed the frame. Now we have to assemble the mesh. I used a simple small board with some nails to tighten the mesh and it works like a charm. I used a big stapler to fasten the mesh easily and tight. Free tip, put all the big and heavy things in first before you assemble the mesh completely. This is much easier than through the double door system. Before we secure the roof, we first put a layer of mesh to prevent the birds from escaping when the roof will be damaged due to the wind or something else. You can never be safe enough. Now, let's get that roof on. Wait a minute, I think this needs a disclaimer. I split the roof in two different parts. One part of the roof will be closed so the birds can shelter from the rain, and one part is open so they can enjoy the sun and on a hot day also enjoy a fresh rainy shower. At the open part of the roof we used a double layer of mesh to prevent predators from reaching in from above. This way they can't just wait and attack the birds when they are at the top. At this point, the aviary is closed off now. The last thing to do is painting the mesh. This will definitely increase the view into the aviary. The paint will block the reflection, which makes it easier to look through. If you have paid attention, you have already seen that before I secured the mesh, I already painted the sides. I've done this beforehand to prevent any paint on the frame of the aviary because I like the wooden look. However, this is up to you. In the next part, I will finish the interior. I will create a natural look with some plants and hiding places for the quills. Click on that subscribe button and notification button so you don't miss anything. Bye bye!